The SDSU women's basketball team is now 6-2 on the year, coming off two more road wins last week. The first came on Thursday at number 25th ranked Arkansas.
Yeah, the Arkansas game was a big challenge. They're a good team. They've got really good SEC players. We'll see where they all kind of rank out. You know, at the end of the year, we'll know more about how good of a win it was. But right now, they were top 25 team, and that says a lot about what they've done so far. We played pretty well in that game, but we didn't play great. They were better than we were for the majority of that game. And it wasn't because the talent level, just because they were making a few more plays. They really hurt us on the glass. They had a ton of offensive rebounds and second chance points. We just didn't have a good rhythm offensively. And then we got down the last kind of 2 minutes, and then we started picking up some momentum. Ultimately, it ended up being a 9-point game with under 30 seconds to go, where you start to think, gosh, is it over? Should we keep fouling? And we just kept making plays. Macy Miller had a 3-point play. Mariah stole an inbound pass, and now all of a sudden the game is in reach. They hit a couple free throws, and Carey hit a big three. They missed a couple free throws, so we're a 3-point game, and we came down and hit the big three to send it to overtime. Then I thought in overtime we really loosened up and played well, to be honest with you. We scored, we did what we had to. But Macy had a great game, China Stevens had a great game. Just made a lot of good plays to sneak out of there with a win.
The big road win was yet another win over a top 25 team for Aaron Johnston's squad. And the head coach says it can really help this team down the road.
Yeah, I think you can build off of wins like that. You know, we had one at Vegas just a couple of days before that, where we got down against UNLV late by 7, came back and won that game. So I think that helped. We talked about that actually in the huddle in the Arkansas game, just to keep playing. And I thought the team really responded well. You have to make some plays to stay in that game. So our team deserves a lot of credit. Arkansas could have made a few that would have probably finished it for them, but we made a lot of plays too. And so I think the team can take that win and build on it. We beat a good team. We had to overcome adversity. We had to make big plays down the stretch. Had to make a ton of big free throws late in that game. We had to execute some sets and inbounds plays. Just so many things we can look back on and feel good about and hopefully be better with in the future.
On Saturday, the Jacks took on former NC seed member Northern Colorado.
Yeah, Northern Colorado, we weren't worried about it as like the quote trap game that people talk about, but coming off of a big win, and then also having been on the road a long time. We were on the road for 11 out of 17 days. That's a long time. And I think our team was just starting to get a little bit tired, so I was worried about fatigue too. Had a real short practice the day before, didn't put a lot of time into it, just kind of talked more than anything, and the team came out and played great. I thought we played as well as we could from start to finish. Defended really well. We rebounded much better. We had really good balance offensively. Rachel Walters came in, hit some big threes for us. Megan Watashik made shots. Macy Miller had another nice game. But I was really pleased with our defense in that game. Northern Colorado's been really good offensively, and we held them in check at their place at the end of a long road trip. So it really showed a lot of resiliency in that game, too.
SDSU has now won 5 straight games, including 4 on the road. And now the head coach wants to see how this team plays at home against good competition.
Well, we're off to a good start. We've had a lot of good wins. I think these next 3 games coming up, Green Bay, Middle Tennessee, and Little Rock, are really going to be great tests for us. All 3 of them are having great years. They're all like us in that they're mid-majors, but very, very good mid-majors. They've all beaten good teams. So I think the next 3 games will give us a real good indication. We've been great on the road so far, but if we can't come home and take care of business, all that kind of goes to waste. So these next 3 games will have a lot better feel for where we're at.
A 3-game homestand begins with Wisconsin-Green Bay tonight at 7 p.m.
Return Megan Vogel. It'll be neat to see her and catch up. I know she's enjoying her experience there, helping their program to be better. But they're a good team. And what makes them a good team is just how tough they are, how hard they play. Every second of every game, they compete. And they're hard to guard offensively because they all shoot the ball well and they can all penetrate. There's really nobody that you look at and think, oh, we can't guard this person or anything like that. You know, they're just really a balanced offensive team. And they've beaten good people. So again, this game to them is going to be just like another game. So we'll have to be ready to go on both ends.
On Monday, Middle Tennessee State will enter Frost Arena, a team SDSU has played several times the past few years.
Yeah, it's almost like a conference game for us at this point to play Middle Tennessee State. We're familiar with each other. No one surprises each other. But it's been great competition for us. And really, it's gone kind of back and forth where home teams have kind of won here in the last chunk of time. This is probably the 8th or 9th time we've played each other in the Division I world. So really athletic, really physical, really tough-minded team. They pound you inside as much as they can. They also have some good shooters on the perimeter as well. Their schedule or their record's a little misleading based on how good they are just because they've played so many good teams. So that'll be another good test, but we're looking forward to it.
And for this team to continue to be successful, Johnston says they have a few wrinkles to iron out.
Where we're at and where we need to get better is valuing the ball still. We still have 4 or 5 bad turnovers every game. Turnovers that are unforced, turnovers that are just concentration turnovers. And in tight games, that's going to be the difference for us. So we got to take care of the ball better. We still have to defend the three-point line better. A big concern of ours going into this week, because both the teams we play shoot it well enough to beat you from the three-point line. Our team needs to show more urgency out there in that area and defend that area better. And then offensively, it's how we attack the basket. We've been shooting the ball well. But we need to have that balance of inside, outside. So we need to be able to get our post players going a little bit more around the basket, a little more penetration, a little more things going to the rim.